తీరునివాసాయ పండరీపురవాసిని పాండురంగ ప్రకాశాయ విఠలాయ నమో నమః మరుత్పుత్రాయ కవయే భీమాయ భయహారిణే శ్రీమదానంద తీర్థాయ ప్రఖ్యాతాయ నమో నమః శివతనయ వరిష్టం సర్వకళ్యాణమూర్తిం పరశుకమలహస్తం శోభితం మోదకేన అరుణకుసుమమాలా వ్యాలలంబోదరం తం మమ హృదయ నివాసం శ్రీగణేశం నమామి కృష్ణవ్రతా కృష్ణమనుస్మరంత రాత్రౌ చ కృష్ణం పునరుత్థితాయై తే కృష్ణదేహా ప్రవిశంతి కృష్ణం ఆజ్యం యథా మంత్రహుతం హుతాశీ బుద్ధిర్బలం యశోధైర్యం నిర్భయత్వమరోగత అజాఢ్యం వాక్పటుత్వం చ హనుమత్స్మరణాత్ భవేత్ చిత్రైపదైశ్చ గంభీరై వాక్యమానైరఖండితై గురుభావం వ్యంజయంతి భాతి శ్రీ జయతీర్థవాక్ ప్రణమత్కామధేనుం చ భజత్సురతరూపమం శ్రీభావబోధకృత్పాద చింతామణిముపాస్మహే పూజ్యాయ రాఘవేంద్రాయ సత్యధర్మరతాయ చ భజతాం కల్పవృక్షాయ నమతాం కామధేనుభి అన్నపూర్ణే సదా పూర్ణే శంకర ప్రాణవల్లభే జ్ఞానవైరాగ్య సిద్ధ్యర్థం భిక్షాం దేహీ చ పార్వతీ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవేతి యో వదేత్ తస్య నిస్సరతే వాణీ జన్ను కన్యా ప్రవాహవత్ రాకాచంద్ర సమాన కాంతివదన నాకాధిరాజస్తుత మూకానామపి కురువతి సురధునీ నీకాశ వాక్వైభవం శ్రీకాంక్షీనగరి విహారరసికా శోకాపహంత్రీ సతాం ఏకా పుణ్యపరంపరా పశుపతే ఆకారిణీ రాజతే సత్యం విధాతుం నిజవృత్యభాషితం వ్యాప్తిం చ భూతేషు అఖిలేషు చాత్మనః అదృశ్యత అత్యద్భుత రూపముద్వహన్ తం భే సభాయాం న మృగం న మానుషం నరసింహ న మృగం న మానుషం సంసార సాగరే మగ్నం భాగవతాఖ్యోయం ప్రత్యక్ష కృష్ణయేవ హి స్వీకృతోసి మయానాథ ముక్త్యర్థం భవసాగరే మనోరథో మదీయోయం సఫల సర్వథా త్వయా నిర్విఘ్నేనైవ కర్తవ్యో దాసోహం తవ కేశవ శుకరూపా ప్రబోధజ్ఞా సర్వశాస్త్ర విశారదా ఏతత్కథా ప్రకాశేన మదజ్ఞానం వినాశయా వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం.
అజామిళ వాజ్ a brahmin, pious brahmin with wife and family and a guru, a very traditional brahmin. He went to pick up firewood for his master. Nobody can summarize Ajamila Charitra better than Bhattadri. Ajamilo nama mahi surapura charan vibho dharma pathan grahashrami gurur gira kanana mitya drishtavan surushta shilam kulatam madakulam. Here was Ajamila Guru Vairappa. He went to collect firewood for his guru's sacrifice, homam, and he saw there a kulata. He saw a lecherous woman, a lustful woman with her parama in an embarrassing posture, and he fell for her. The moment he saw her, he fell for her. Kamayesha, krodhayesha, rajoguna samudbhavaha. The Lord tells Arjuna, this is why man falls. From that day, he left his family, children, guru, everything, and began to live a life of sin with her. And when he lived a life of sin with her, he begot several children. But, Guru Vairappa, there's a saving grace. Always remember, there is a bank balance, a spiritual bank balance. Whatever good you do is there in your spiritual bank balance. Nahi kalyana krit kachit durgatim tata gachati. In the sixth chapter, Arjuna is asking, while doing sadhana, suppose we get cut off, do you mean we come back to square one? No. If you studied in the fourth standard in this school, take the school leaving certificate, you start off with the fifth standard in the next school. That is how we get promoted. That is how we carry our spiritual bank balance. Whatever you are doing, one day's Bhagavatam is enough, my dear listeners. One shloka from the Gita is enough. 108 times mala of the Lord is enough. One flower is enough. One deepam is enough. One fruit is enough. One drop of tear for the Lord is enough. The Lord records it, my dear listeners. The Lord records it. Patram pushpam phalam toyam yo me bhakti aprechati. He had done so much of tapasya that he named one of his children Narayana. Guru Vairappa, he loved one child, and that child had your name. Dadhau bhavan namayute sute ratim. He loved only that child. Which child? Whose name was Narayana. Time was gone, and now came the time of death. And Ajamila saw three terrible looking messengers of death. Samrutyu kale yamaraja kinkaran bhayankaran trin abhilakshayan bhiya puramanaktvat spritivasana balat juhava narayana namakam sutam narayana. He called out to the child. What can that little child do? No, Guru Vairappa. He was calling out your name, Guru Vairappa. It was not the child. You reminded him. Tell the Lord, I may forget you, Krishna. Don't make me forget you. Don't make me forget you. Matta smriti jnanam apohanam cha. The Lord reminds. The Lord reminds you of himself. And then you're a changed person. And what happened? Because he called out Narayana, dial Narayana, there came four dutas from Vaikuntha. These are terrible, those are beautiful. Durashayasya pitadatva nirgata tvadiya namakshara matra vaibhavat puro vipetu bhavadiya parshada chaturbhuja pitapata manorama. Lovely people wearing yellow silk and looking exactly like Vishnu Swarupa. Four of them are standing there. How did they come? Because of your name. Twadiya namakshara matra vaibhavat. The dasas of Karnataka tell Panduranga, we don't want you. We don't want your shankha, chakra, gada, padma, pitambara. Panduranga says, why are you angry with me? We just want your name, Panduranga. Neen yako, ninna hang yako, ninna namada bala undiddare saku. Enough if we have your Nama. Nama and Krishna are one and the same. He is Shabda Brahma. That is the one who gives you the strength. That is the one who gives you the energy. Ordinary talk can make you totally depleted. Totally you will become tired. No doubt about it. Sometimes you get tired with people talking to you on the phone and you switch off the phone. But when you chant the name of the Lord, you become charged. That is why his name and he are admired. You cannot take him away. What is death? simple definition of death. Taking the sukshma sharira from the sthula sharira, that is all. There is one small sharira like this within us, that the soul, small one. The messengers of death come with the noose and take that small sharira from this big sharira. It falls down dead. And that is the one that is going to suffer hell or heaven, as the case may be. When they try to take away this small sharira, our people, our Vishnu Dutas say, no, 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 he belongs to us. Oh no, we cannot make a mistake. The only one among the demigods of heaven who is called Dharma is Yama. We don't call Vayu Dharma, Varuna Dharma, Agni Dharma, only Yama Dharma. Yama is the only one who does Dharma. That is why he is known as Yama Dharma. No, sir, we can't go wrong. We know who he is and we know how many sins he has committed. We've got the whole resume, the entire thing, printout is here. The men of God say, all that is forgotten. What do you mean? He has repented. Where was the time for repentance? He chanted the name of the Lord. That was not the Lord's name. It was the Son's name. But it is one and the same. Narayana is one and the same. My master used to say, whether you dial 100 or your grandchild dials 100, the police says hello. My dear listeners, please remember that. Knowingly or unknowingly, you call the Lord comes. That is the logic of the men of God. If you call him knowingly, how happy he will be. If you listen to his Bhagavatam, how happy he'll be. There are two examples they give. Knowingly, if you take a medicine, well and good. Even if you don't know the name of the medicine, but the doctor says, swallow the tablet and you do it, the disease gets cured. Similarly, unknowing the name of the Lord, not knowing the power of the name of the Lord, you chant it, your sins will be totally wiped out. Second, knowingly or unknowingly, you take a piece of wood to the fire, it will burn. Similarly, knowingly or unknowingly, you chant the name of the Lord, sins get burned. Another advantage of Nama Sankirtana, the whole of this hall is not built on a foundation, it is built on Nama Sankirtana. Please clap for Guruji. I remember the days when the whole hall would vibrate with the names of the Lord. That is what all great men have done in Pandharpur. People who know about Pandharpur say that Pandharpur is a bazaar of names. Namacha Bazaar, Pandari Namacha Bazaar. You find you give Nama and you take Nama. That's the barter. That's the way business goes on there. My dear listeners, here is an argument from the men of God. If there is a poisonous plant in your garden, you cut it up to the root, it'll sprout again. There are certain prayaschittas for certain sins. There are certain ways of redemption. When you commit a sin, according to the scriptures, you can do these prayaschittas and get rid of the sin. But you will commit the sin again. Whereas, if you uproot the tree, if you take it out, jadon mulita, you take out the root of the tree, then it will never sprout again. When you chant the name of the Lord, even the proclivity to sin, the inclination to sin is also removed, my dear listeners. That is why we chant the name of the Lord. Nama purifies. The name of the Lord purifies. The men of God are telling him, Shruti smritibhyam vita vratadaya punanti papam lunanti vasanam ananta seva tunikranta tidvayim iti prabhu tvat purusha babhashire. Guru Vairappa, did your men, Vishnu Dutas, not say this? And Guru Vairappa, 475 years back, went drifting into the life of sin. What a change has come over me, that God forgives me even at this last moment. Kvachaham kitava prapapu brahmagno nirapatrapaha kvacha narayana ittetat bhagavan nama mangalam. He is given a longer lease of life. He repents for what he has done and finally achieves the feet of the Lord. This beautiful episode ends with this question. Somebody on his deathbed chanted Narayana and attained the Lord. Then what about those of us who are doing sadhana every day and praying to Narayana? What about this? Kim punaha shraddhaya granan. This is how the beautiful episode of Ajamila comes to an end. We go back to the Saptama Skanda. In the Saptama Skanda, towards the end, there's a conversation between Yudhishthira and Naradji. The same thing is repeated between Shukadeva and Parikshit. Parikshit wants to know what are the good virtues to be adopted. Sadachara Nirnaya. We want to know what are the good qualities to be adopted in life. What is a good life? What is the definition of a good life? What are the virtues to be adopted? Question is asked by Parikshit. Answer is given by Shukadeva. And quoting what Yudhishthira was told by Naradji. After talking about Dharma, Satya, Ahimsa, etc., Dana, Punya, everything. Finally, you have a climactic compliment given to the Pandavas. The whole family had monopolized Krishna. Mother Kunti had made him a permanent SOS. Arjuna made him a non-paid chauffeur. Yudhishthira made him an honorary ambassador. Draupadi made him a textile mill. Parikshit made him a co-tenant in his mother's womb. Are you not jealous of the family of the Pandavas? How much privilege they enjoyed. How much privilege, the vicinity of the Lord, the proximity of the divine. That is what makes you feel jealous. Here is Naradji saying, all of us go towards a good life so that we can reach God. You follow a good life to reach God. Suppose God is already with you. Why do you need a good life? You Pandavas, you don't have to go after a good life because God is coming to your home uninvited every day, my dears. The gods in heaven are jealous of you. We go and ask Krishna, do something. Krishna goes to Yudhishthira in the Mahabharata and asks, what can I do for you? That is the love he has for them. That is the love. He loved them so much. Whenever I read this shloka, my eyes are clouded with tears. Yuyam Riloki Batabhuri Bhaga Lokam Punana Munayo Vyanti Esham Grihan Avasatiti Sakshat Gudham Param Brahma Manushyalingam. Krishna, the Divine One, under the camouflage of a human being, comes to your home every day. What can I talk about you? How can I describe your good fortune? Yuyam Riloke Batabhuri Bhaga Lokam Punana Munayo Bhiyanti Esham Grihan. You don't have to go to him, he comes to you. Esham Grihan. He stays there. Avasatiti Sakshat Gudham Param Brahma Manushyalingam. One episode comes to my mind from the Mahabharata. The Mahabharata and the Bhagavata have to be read together. Only then you'll understand the love that Krishna had for the Pandavas. One day, it is decided that the entire Pandava clan should be wiped out. Yudhishthira gets nervous. Overnight, Krishna says, Draupadi, come with me. It's one of those episodes in the Upakatha. And he tells Draupadi at night, come along with me. Take two shawls. It's quite cold and we will cover ourselves. And both of them are walking across the battlefield to go to the enemy's camp. And as they're walking, Mother Draupadi's shoes are making a lot of noise. He says, shoo, give me your shoes. The Lord takes her shoes and holds them in his hand. Quietly they go, softly. They reach Bhishma's tent. Bhishma is planning for the next day, how to wipe out the Pandavas. And as he is lost in military strategy, thought about the next day's military plan, the wonderful woman called Draupadi goes and falls at his feet and says, Namaste. Not knowing who she is, he says, Dirga Sumangali Bhava. May your husband live long. Then he looks at her. She takes off her veil. Krishna, Draupadi, who brought you here? My maid, sir. Oh, your maid brought you here at midnight. I want to see the maid. And he walks out of the tent. The Lord is standing there, covering his head with the shawl. Bhishma says, maid, unveil yourself. The Lord takes off the shawl and the shoes of Draupadi fall from his hand. Bhishma says, Draupadi, a family in which Krishna carries your shoes, why are you afraid of being defeated, my dear? Why are you afraid? He is there to serve you. That is the power you enjoy. With the Master of Heaven, he is the one who has come to serve you. That is the Lord's love for the Pandavas. My dear listeners, bow down to the 8th canto now. Time is passing. We have to go to meet two proud people in the 8th canto. One is Gajendra. All of us are proud, knowingly or unknowingly. There's something about us which is very unpleasant, and that is that three-letter word called E-G-O. The entire Gita is based on that ego. All our problems are based on ego. Whenever I see ego, I say you go. The moment I become humble, I'm very happy. The moment I'm proud, I suffer. When you're humble, nobody can insult you. Nobody can talk ill of you. Anybody can say anything. And like Jadavarta, you say Narayana. You say Narayana. But if you have ego, oh God, it hurts. The whole night you can't sleep. Unfortunately for people in power, ego comes very easily. There was a proud elephant called Gajendra. Already the elephant's stature is such, its figure is such, that it looks proud. There are so many books on body language nowadays. The way you sit, the way you talk, the way you smile, the way you greet, everything. Everything is only exposing your true nature. The Gaja always walks with a swagger because he's very proud of it. Power is a very strong animal. I hope you know that the elephant is the strongest animal, not even the lion. Please clap for the elephant. You know why I asked you to clap? Because he's a strict vegetarian. Second clap. Children think you become strong only when you eat non-veg. No. I tell them the greatest champion for vegetarianism is the elephant. Under no circumstance will the elephant eat non-veg. No. Never. This Gajendra had a big following, whole majority following him. Elephants, she elephant, female elephant, baby elephant, all of them having a gala time. When you're in a party, do you ever remember God? Oh no, nobody remembers God's in a party. That's why we people don't go to parties. Maddening it is. Everybody's talking about everybody. Nobody's thinking of the master of the world. That is why parties make you dizzy. In several ways, they make you giddy. Here is Gajendra, happily enjoying a bath in a pool of water on a warm afternoon. But then, my dear listeners, what is Gajendra Charitra teaching us? It is teaching us that calamity can befall at any time. My father was a good student of Telugu and used to always quote Potana and say, Potana describes the way Narayana comes when Gajendra calls out. Gajendra is now happy. When you're happy, you don't think of the Lord. That's why I said, during the weddings, you don't think of the Lord. During a funeral, you are reminded of the Lord. Now, as he is happy, suddenly something catches his foot. That happens in life. Amidst life, the activities of life, suddenly there is a halt, break. You ask, what is it? What is it he is asking? An aquatic creeper? No. Small creature? No. Small fish? No. What is it? Alligator. It's an angry crocodile. Oh God, please help me out. Help me out, he's asking. And everybody, all the elephants make one row, one line, and they are trying to pull him out of disaster. Very symbolic, my dear listeners. Wherever I speak to businessmen, I tell businessmen, I hope the auditors are also listening. Here is Gajendra saying, where is he? Where is he? My friend, my relative, all of them are gone. 12 days people come and mourn with us, or pretend to mourn with us. After that, even our own son goes back to New York and asks, Mommy, after Papa died, how much money do you want? You don't want money, you want love. You want concern, you want commitment. You want a commitment from the child that he will love you forever. No, my dear listeners, no. Nobody stands by you. It is then that the ego of man is still lurking. I told you, ego is like cancer. It takes a long time to go. Not only does it take a long time to go, it comes back again and again. Next checkup, the doctor says there are traces. That is how ego is. Again, there's a trace of ego. That ego trace tells him, I will fight my battle alone, self-confidence, blah, blah. I have got my self-confidence, my degrees, my experience, my proficiency. You are nothing. When calamity strikes, calamity is like a mountain crushing a squirrel. Then you say, oh God, I can't bear it anymore. I can't bear it anymore. What is the way out? Someone said there is a God. I don't know his name. I never prayed to him. His email ID, I don't know. His phone number, I don't know. His form, I don't know. His qualities, I don't know. But I've heard that he is the master of the world. Oh God, if you are there, listen to me. Listen to me. Desperate Gajendra calling out in a lonely valley, caught in the pool of life. Life is so difficult sometimes that without the help of God, you cannot move on. That is why before you become desperate, chant the name of the Lord. And the Lord is there. There is no doubt about it. He is there. He is asking, you who create the world, sustain the world, destroy the world, I bow down to you. From whom the world comes, into whom the world goes, by whom the world is sustained, I bow down to you. You are the cause of the world, the causeless cause of the world. I bow down to you. Namo namaste akhila karanaya, nishkaranaya, adbhuta karanaya, wonderful cause of the world. The Nobel Prize people who have been given the Nobel Prize in physics, three of them had discovered a particle. Not knowing what to call it, they call it God's particle. Please give them big. Namo namaste akhila karanaya, nishkaranaya, adbhuta karanaya. They don't know how to explain it, so they call it God's particle. It has to be. There must be some inexplicable mystery. Call it by any name you want, but we call him Krishna.